What is this that Osteen is teaching? Where does this teaching come from? This prosperity word of faith theology, name it and claim it, or think and speak positive and you will get what your heart desires belief, is actually an old New Age occult concept known as the law of attraction, or thought power, as I mentioned. And its origins are not Christian. This belief comes from the New Thought movement of the late 19th and early 20th centuries, as well as the mystics of the New Age Theosophical Society in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. It was then picked up by much of the New Age movement as a whole. You may recognize the phrase Law of Attraction from the movie The Secret, which came out in 2006, and this film is based on the same principle. That film and its teachings were and are highly endorsed by the influential New Age television host Oprah Winfrey, who is heavily involved with the occult.
This show, this is what I've been trying to do. It is the secret to creating the life you truly want. Make more money, lose weight, fall in love, land your dream job. Isn't that amazing? This is life-changing.
I'm ready for that, yeah.
Okay, now the choir's going. Jump in, anybody. Find out the secret and see why people everywhere are talking about it.
When I heard that for the first time, my eyes watered.
Now, this law of attraction belief is also endorsed by New Age guru and author Deepak Chopra, who denies Christianity. Notice how similar Joel Osteen's Word of Faith thought power teachings are to the Law of Attraction teachings found in the New Age movie, The Secret, even when it comes down to the magnet analogy that Joel Osteen used.
You know, this secret gives you everything you want. Happiness, health, and wealth.
You can have, do, or be anything you want.
We can have whatever it is that we choose. I don't care how big it is.
What kind of a house do you want to live in?
Do you want to be a millionaire?
What kind of a business do you want to have?
Do you want more success?
What do you really want? One law. It's attraction.
The simplest way for me to look at the law of attraction is if I think of myself as a magnet, and I know that a magnet will attract to it. Our job as humans is to hold on to the thoughts of what we want, make it absolute clear in our minds what we want, and from that we start to invoke one of the greatest laws in the universe, and that's the law of attraction. You become what you think about most, but you also attract what you think about most.
And that principle can be summed up in three simple words. Thoughts become things.
Now get up and say, this is going to be a great day. I'm excited about my future. Something good is going to happen to me. You've got to send your words out in the direction you want your life to go.
Notice that in this man-centered teaching, there is nothing about Christ or the Bible, and yet Joel Osteen teaches it. Osteen doesn't inform his viewers that this is what he is teaching them. He just teaches it as if it is Christianity, thereby deceiving many to think it's actually biblical Christianity. He has included this false heretical law of attraction belief into his teachings, applying it to the Bible, thereby introducing modern New Age metaphysical concepts into the church and distorting the true biblical gospel, diluting it of its meaning and original message. We will talk about why this unbiblical belief, not found in Scripture, is dangerous and what it results in. But let us first examine some more of its origins to see the gravity of the situation. So where did Osteen, Oprah Winfrey, Deepak Chopra, and the movie The Secret get this view from? This view can be traced back to a New Age organization called the Theosophical Society. The Theosophical Society was a group of New Age mystics who firmly believed and taught that Lucifer was the true God or Messiah. The Theosophical Society was founded by Helena Blavatsky, who said, "But in antiquity and reality, Lucifer or Luciferus is the name of the angelic entity presiding over the light of truth as over the light of the day. Lucifer is divine and terrestrial light, the Holy Ghost and Satan at one and the same time. And now it stands proven that Satan or the red fiery dragon, the Lord of Phosphorus, and Lucifer or light bearer is in us. It is our mind." Unquote. Helena Blavatsky and Blavatsky's students believed that Satan was God, denied the truth of Jesus Christ, as well as the gospel. The Theosophical Society grew into what we now call the New Age movement of today, as their teachings about the New Age of Aquarius spread. Now, when I found out that it was actually these early theosophists who popularized what Joel Osteen is now teaching, I was truly at awe. With respect to Osteen's teaching that types of thoughts, be they good or bad, attract types of results, be they good or bad, i.e. the law of attraction, Blavatsky wrote the following in 1887, quote, "It is the universal law which is understood by Plato and explained in Timaeus as the attraction of lesser bodies to larger ones, and of similar bodies to similar, the latter exhibiting a magnetic power rather than following the law of gravitation," unquote. Blavatsky's New Age Luciferian occultist students, such as Annie Besant, also taught and popularized this law of attraction, positive thought, Joel Osteen belief. Besant wrote the following in 1903, quote, "This is the secret of right receptivity. The mind responds according to its constitution. It answers to all that is of like nature with itself. We make it positive towards evil, negative towards good, by habitual good thinking, thus building into its very fabric materials that are receptive of good, unreceptive of evil. We must think of that which we desire to receive, and refuse to think of that which we desire not to receive," unquote. This is where Joel Osteen's power of thought belief stems from. Notice how man-centered this occult New Age belief is. We must think of what we desire to receive. Where is Christ or submission to holiness in all of this? The emphasis of this teaching is selfish fulfillment of one's carnal desires and dreams, using their own mental power of thought to attain it, when, in contrast, the Bible that Christians are ordered to follow exhorts Christians to submit to the lordship of Christ in all things, dying to self and dying to worldly desires. 1 John 2:15-17 states, "Do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the desires of the flesh and the desires of the eyes and pride in possessions, is not from the Father, but is from the world. And the world is passing away along with its desires, but whoever does the will of God abides forever," unquote. Hence, why are pastors like Osteen making it their duty to tell people to use this occult power of thought belief to attain things of the world that the Bible orders Christians not to focus on? In fact, in the Gospel of Mark, chapter 8, verse 36, it asks, "For what does it profit a man to gain the whole world and forfeit his soul?" unquote. So again, one must ask this crucial question. Why does a pastor of a mega church teach what is contrary to scripture and what comes from the New Age movement of the 19th century? We will go more into that later. Now, regarding further origins of this belief, William Walker Atkinson, born 1862 and died in 1932, was also a New Age occultist, and he drew his teachings from the false religion of Hinduism. He helped popularize the law of attraction or thought power belief into American thinking as well, teachings that eventually found their way into Joel Osteen's pulpit. The occultist Atkinson wrote, quote, "We speak learnedly of the law of gravitation, but ignore that equally wonderful manifestation, the law of attraction, in the thought world. We are familiar with that wonderful manifestation of law, which draws and holds together the atoms of which matter is comprised. We recognize the power of the law that attracts bodies to earth, that holds the circling worlds in their places, but we close our eyes to the mighty law that draws to us the things we desire or fear, that makes or mars our lives," unquote. This is exactly what Joel Osteen is teaching his church to do. The same occult philosophy of people who believed in the occult, the New Age, and Luciferianism. Yet he doesn't inform his congregation about where these thought power teachings come from. Instead of informing those under him that his teachings come from people who believed Satan was the true God, and that man's goal is to live for himself in a selfish manner, using thought power to attain material success, Osteen just teaches this thought power doctrine, as if Jesus taught such a thing. Joel Osteen is not preaching Christianity, he's preaching New Age occultism. Commenting on the link between Osteen's teachings and the occult notion of law of attraction and thought power, Dr. Ronald Bish notes the following in his work Jesus, the Way, the Truth, and the Life, quote, "For Rhonda Byrne, the genie is the law of attraction. For Joel Osteen, it's the word of faith, And so he's committed to the notion that faith is a force, that words are the container's force, and through the force of faith, you can create your own reality, unquote. This New Age law of attraction belief was also taught long ago by heretical false anti-Christian people, such as Phineas P. Quimby and Mary Baker Eddy of the late 19th century, and it slowly found its way into Christian churches after the 19th century, becoming what is now known today as the Word of Faith movement, or Prosperity Gospel message, present in Joel Osteen's sermons. Essek W. Kenyon, born 1867, died in 1948, incorporated this satanic man-centered belief into Christian churches, and it resulted in final acceptance since so many followed after him. Now much of the church believes this self-help, think positive thought power message to be the gospel, when it is actually counterproductive to the truth of Christianity, which has always emphasized submission to the lordship of Christ, denial of self, and denial of worldliness. This belief wants you to focus on worldliness and attain the material possessions and happiness your heart desires using thought power, except this time, you combine God with thought power, and you will get everything you want. This kind of teaching appeals to natural, carnal, sinful people who want material possessions as opposed to giving up worldliness to submit to God as the Bible commands. However, Osteen's beliefs are revolting to real biblical Christians who follow Jesus when he said in Matthew 16:24, quote, "Anyone who would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me," unquote. This unbiblical, worldly, occult, New Age, name it and claim it law of attraction belief was then promoted by popular preacher Kenneth Hagin, which then sadly gave this type of doctrine more prominence and acceptance in the church setting.
Now, I tell people all the time, if you're not satisfied with what you have, you've created it yourself. I know you laid it on somebody else, but you created it yourself. Well, if you're not satisfied with what you have, quit believing what you're believing and saying what you're saying. And start believing what you want created and saying what you want done. And it will become.
All things are possible to him.
Now shut your eyes and say it out loud. Listen to your own voice as you say it. All things are possible to him that believeth. Say it again.
All things are possible to him that believeth.
Say this, and I believe. Now let's say it together. All things are possible to him that believeth, and I believe.
All things are possible to him that believeth, and I believe.
Say it again.
Such modern false teachers who now corrupt the church with this poisonous false doctrine include T.D. Jakes, Joyce Meyer, Benny Hinn, Kenneth Copeland, and of course Joel Osteen, and many others.
That as these programs are airing, I'm speaking something into existence.
Therefore, when Osteen teaches people that God wants you to use thought power to attain material success, possessions, and happiness, he is not teaching Christianity. He is merely repeating the occult law of attraction thought power beliefs that slowly crept in and corrupted the church in the last 125 years or so. You will never find such a teaching in the Christian church before that, because the Bible doesn't teach such a heresy.